Also, there is this Islamic legend that is very popular that Dhul-Qarnayn is somehow Alexander the Great. And the fact of the matter is that there is not a shred of Islamic or historical evidence that links Alexander the Great with Dhul-Qarnayn. In fact, quite the contrary, there's a number of things that do not fit at all with Alexander the Great and Dhul-Qarnayn. The most important of them, Allah describes Dhul-Qarnayn as being a pious Muslim, a good man. As a rajul salih, as Ibn Abbas said, and we know historically beyond a shadow of a doubt that Alexander the Great was a pagan idolater. He was an idol worshipper. His teacher was none other than Aristotle. Aristotle was the tutor of Alexander the Great. This is literally historically. Alexander the Great was tutored by Aristotle. And these people were not believers in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They believed in a pagan religion. So Alexander the Great has nothing to do with the story of Dhul-Qarnayn. So فَأَتْبَعَ سَبَبًا. His army goes and follows away. They're going and following in one location. حَتَّى إِذَا بَلَغَ مَغْرِبَ الشَّمْسِ. When he reached the setting place of the sun, meaning he reached the westernmost lands imaginable. And some have said this is China, some have said Samarkand, some have said Azerbaijan, whatever it might be, he reached some type of lands, Allah knows where the sun sets, very far in the lands. حَتَّى إِذَا بَلَغَ مَغْرِبَ الشَّمْسِ وَجَدَهَا تَغْرُبُ فِي عَيْنٍ حَمِئَةٍ. He found that the sun was setting in, there's two recitations here. Ayn al-Hamia means cloudy water, and then there's another qira'ah, Ayn al-Hamia, boiling hot water. And both of these are valid. So it was a strange type of lake. It was not a regular lake. It was a lake that was muddy and very hot. And some have said this might be lava or something of this nature. Allah knows best. It was something different rather than regular water. It's something different. Ayn al-Hamia. Wa wajada 'indaha qawma. And they found, he found over there a group of people. قُلْنَا يَا ذَا الْقَرْنَيْنِ. We said, O Dhul-Qarnayn, you have two options. Meaning, it came to Dhul-Qarnayn's mind, I have so much power, what can I do with these people? I can either punish them or I can be good to them. And this is what every king, when they conquer a new nation, they have this option. So Allah is demonstrating what is the nature of Dhul-Qarnayn. He had the option of massacring, of killing, of being harsh, and the option of being good. So what did he do? Dhul-Qarnayn said, قال أما من ظلم فسوف نعذبه ثم يرد إلى ربه فيعذبه عذابا نكرا. Whoever has done wrong, if he is a criminal, a murderer, a rapist, this person, we will punish him. And we will give him what is due to him, and then Allah will punish him even more in the next life. وَأَمَّا مَنْ آمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. But whoever believes and does good, فَلَهُ جَزَاءً الْحُسْنَى. He shall have the ultimate reward, which means, of course, Jannah. وَسَنَقُولُ لَهُمْ أَمْرِنَا يُسْرًا. And as for us, we will be gentle and easy with him. Now this is the sign of a just and a true ruler, that you're strict with the criminals, and you are gentle with the good people. So the first, there's three stories of Dhul-Qarnayn, three people that he met. The first incident demonstrates for us the nature of Dhul-Qarnayn. That Dhul-Qarnayn was a righteous king. That the power did not corrupt him. That the power did not get to his head. He had the option of enslaving, of killing, of looting, of plundering. And he had the option of being generous and good. And he chose the option of being a good king. And that was, those who do wrong will be punished and Allah will punish them even more, and those who are good, we will reward them. So this shows us the nature of Dhul-Qarnayn. ثُمَّ أَتْبَعَ سَبَبًا. Then he followed another road. حَتَّى إِذَا بَلَغَ مَطْلِعَ الشَّمْسِ. Now he found the sun rising. So this is some land in the east. He found the sun rising. وَجَدَهَا تَطْلُعُ عَلَى قَوْمٍ لَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُمْ مِنْ دُونِهَا سِتْرًا. He found that this group had nothing to protect them from the sun.